Today, 4029 News learned a 6-year-old Jersey Bridgeman's body was released from the state crime lab and taken to Rollins Funeral Home in Rogers. Family and friends are gathering there right now for visitation. 4029's Jay Plyburn spoke with Jersey's school principal this afternoon, and he joins us live from the visitation with more on how the school is explaining all of this to Jersey's friends.
Yeah, friends and family of Jersey Bridgeman are gathered behind me here at Rollins Funeral Home for the visitation, which just got underway a few minutes ago. Jersey's body was found last Tuesday in a vacant home, but today is the first day back at school, and many of the students are having a tough time dealing with this situation. People paying their respects tonight include administrators from Sugar Creek Elementary, where Jersey was a kindergartner. Earlier today, teachers at the school broke the news to all the children and answered any questions they might have. Pam Blair, the school principal, says they did not provide much information to the students other than the facts that Jersey Bridgeman died and police are still investigating. Faculty members allowed the students to write and draw pictures about how they were feeling, which helped determine who needed the most intensive counseling. Blair says it was the older students in third and fourth grade who had the toughest time with it. 35 to 40 students needed counseling.
And these were kids that rode the bus with Jersey or lived in the neighborhood with her. And so they were the ones that actually saw the events unfold.
She says many of the students questioned their own safety, which is typical in a situation like this. Overall, though, she says it went well today for the school and everyone in it. We'll have more on this story coming up at 6. Live tonight, Jay Plyburn, 4029 News.
Thanks, Jay. Now, we've just talked to Bentonville Police Chief John Simpson, and he says he's not releasing any more information about the case.